This is Creepy Sombra and my channel Creepy Travels. This time I invite you to Prague, the capital of Czech Republic. This place had a lot of creepy history and myths and legends. We will visit the Josefov Quarter, which used to be the Jewish ghetto, and of course its most famous monument, the Old Jewish Cemetery of Prague. The cemetery was used since the 15th century till the 18th, and there are many interesting people buried there, among them Rabbi Yehuda Lev and also Mordechai Meisel. Later I will tell you something more about both of them. The space on the cemetery was limited, of course, and it was not easy for the Jews to get a proper burial ground, and because their faith prohibited them from destroying the old graves, they brought a large amount of soil, covered them, and so they were able to bury people basically in layers. So you can find 12 layers of buried dead on this cemetery. You can imagine the zombie apocalypse Jewish style in Prague. During history, the Jews were often persecuted. So Rabbi Lev, who lived in 17th century, made a guardian for them out of clay, a homunculus, a robot, we could say, a thing that then became known as the Golem of Prague. The remnants of the Golem are rumored to be hidden in the attic of the old new synagogue. Legend has it that this synagogue was found in the ground already built. The Jews only had to unearth it, so by the will of God, they got the whole building ready. That's why it's called Old New Synagogue. It is also said that the dead Jews come to pray to the synagogue at night. So when somebody comes in the morning, he has to knock with the key on the door 3 times loudly to let the dead know that now the living are coming to prayer. And there must be a lot of ghosts, because there were pogroms, murdering of the Jews during history, and on one occasion even inside the synagogue. At the end of the 14th century, it is said that the blood of the victims is still on the walls. The attic of the synagogue and the remnants of the Golem are still shrouded in mystery. Rabbi Lev had to destroy or deactivate the Golem because it went berserk, so they had the rise of the machines before it was cool. To be activated or brought to life, the Golem needs a shem, which is the shortened version of the word Shem Hamforash, meaning a hidden name of God. It was written right on the Golem's forehead or on a paper put into his mouth, or the rabbi had to hang it around the Golem's neck. It is said that some people tried to find the Golem and revive him, including some agent of the Nazis, but all have failed miserably. Now let's have a look at Mordechai Meisel. He was the contemporary of Rabbi Lev and moved at the court of Rudolf II. Meisel was actually very rich and used his money to develop the ghetto, to build synagogues, etc. The legend says that his money came from a mysterious treasure which he gained from dwarfs or spirits, who said it can be gained only by a very honest person. The Meisel Synagogue in Prague still bears the philanthropist's name. The Spanish Synagogue is the youngest synagogue in Prague. It was built in the 19th century in place of the oldest synagogue in Prague, which was from 12th century. It's called Spanish because of the style of decoration, which was inspired by the Spanish Alhambra. It stands in the Dušní street, meaning Spirit Street. Next to it, we can find a statue dedicated to the writer Franz Kafka and also the Church of the Holy Ghost. The statue was inspired by Kafka's short story, A Description of a Struggle, and the complete figure represents Kafka himself. The Church of the Holy Spirit was built in the 14th century. In the 16th century, the Jews from the nearby ghetto were forced to go there to listen to Catholic preaching, which I think is a special level of creepiness. I really wondered whom depicts the statue in front of the church. To my surprise, it's John of Nepomuk, a favorite Czech saint and martyr, but he is usually depicted with five stars around his head and a crucifix. Here he is as an almsgiver, so I was mightily confused. By the church of St. Nicholas at Old Town Square used to stand a monastery. The legend says that a beautiful Jewish girl fell in love with a young monk, but the abbot found out about it and ordered the young monk to be secretly taken away. It is said that the Jewish girl lost her mind and she strangled the abbot. Since then, they both appear as ghosts nearby. So that's all for tonight. See you next time. And remember, don't worry, be creepy.